Hello, thank you for this opportunity. I want to talk to you about science and technology, and I want to present you with a challenge. And I'm particularly focusing on the students in attendance of this event. It's my pleasure to talk to you, speak to you about some of my views about technology. I want to start with the science. You know, it was about 50 years ago, about 50 years ago that the Saturn V rocket was launched. It was about 300 feet tall, and it had about 6 million pounds of thrust. It's a very, very powerful rocket. Today, the technology has moved forward to the point where we've got literally space launches have been commercialized. Private companies are putting up their own satellite networks for communications and other things. But technology has moved forward very, very aggressively, and we continue to push. At my company, we're working on new energy technology for the environment. We have a glass electrolyte, for example, for making solid state batteries. I've invented a new engine that will convert heat directly into electricity. And of course, all of these inventions are being patented so that we can protect it from an intellectual property perspective. I learned my lesson with Super Soaker. I think if I had not had patent protections on the technology, there's no way I would have profited from the success of that invention to the point where I can do the work that I'm doing today to address some of the environmental challenges that the world is facing. But I want to talk about and focus on technology. Let's use computers as an example. Computers are tools. We use this as a tool, computers as a tool, you know, to do other things. For example, plan a meal, build a bridge, go to the moon, whatever. It's a tool. But we have to be able to use these tools, technology tools, but we've got to dream about really, really big ideas like going to the moon, going back to Mars, for example. Dreams, imagination, inspiration, that's star stuff. That's where the motivation comes from to really encourage us and push us forward as improving technology and improving quality of life. People are like snowballs rolling down a snow-covered hill. The further they roll, the bigger they get. The self-esteem, identity, experience, they're all interlinked with each other. So if you have an identity and that identity, you define it and you should seek it out and understand who you are and where you are and where you're going and make sure you're on the right kind of hill. For example, mistakes can lead to consequences. If the consequences are too severe or inappropriate, they can actually lead to injury to one's self-esteem. And a pattern of such events can lead to a low self-esteem and low self-identity. You could identify yourself as someone who gets into trouble. Well, you know, that pride steps in and we all have that. And you may decide that you're going to be a big troublemaker. You're going to be the best at what you can do. Well, that's not really the kind of hill you want to be on. If you experience success and reward leads to positive feedback, you want more success. Success can become very addictive. And you want to continue to take the risk to achieve even more success because those positive experiences are what you want to do and what you want to have to reinforce who you are and the path that you're on in life. So don't shy away from challenges and things that where you think you may be able to succeed. Put your effort into it so that you have that success and do indeed achieve what you set out to do. We live in a prosperous time. We're surrounded by wealth and abundance, but we've all seen people, we've all seen homelessness, we've all seen hunger and disease. We've certainly experienced disease with the latest COVID outbreak that has affected all of us. We in the U.S. consume about 25% of the world's energy. But we're only about 5% of the world's population. Well, it turns out that energy consumption is a reflection of quality of life. You know, most of the world does not have the quality of life that we do have here in the United States. But those countries who are third world countries in particular that don't have quite the quality of life that we have, they're busy trying to lift their populations out of poverty and improve the quality of life. So as that starts to happen, more and more energy is going to be consumed in the world. So the challenge that we're facing is to find a way, engineer a way to share the prosperity that we enjoy here in the US with the rest of the world. That means developing the technology, renewable energy technology, which is one of the areas where my company is focused, but being able to share that with the world so that the entire world can experience prosperity without relying on the environmentally damaging fossil fuels that have gotten us to the point where we're seeing catastrophic events in the world. So you are the emerging leaders, the ones, the people who are truly in the arena in terms of taking on the challenges that we will deal with in the future. And you must use whatever tools that are available to you, resources that God has given you. But please remember my favorite quote, because in the arena, it's not the critic who counts. It's not the man who stumbles or who points out how the strong man could have done better. The credit belongs to the man who's actually in the arena, whose face is marred with dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs and comes up short again and again. But there's no effort without error and shortcoming. But who, in the end, actually strives to do the deeds, who knows the great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, and who at best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, but who also at worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly, so that his place will never be among those cold and timid souls who know neither victory nor defeat. Thank you so much for this opportunity to speak with you. I hope that something I've said has inspired you to, you know, take on some of the tough challenges in the world and have a huge, huge impact. Good luck to you all.